Hi guys! Welcome sa Engie Nerdmat Channel. Sa video na to ay tuturo ko sa inyo ang integration using new substitution part 2. So kung gusto nyo itong matutunan, just keep on watching. Okay, so sa video na to is mag-integrate ulit tayo using new substitution. So part 2 na ito. Dun sa part 1 is gumamit tayo ng new substitution to integrate particularly focused on algebraic functions. Ngayon, magsasolve tayo ng integral still using new substitution pero magkakaroon tayo ng transcendental functions. Okay, so kung hindi nyo pa napapanood yung integration using new substitution part 1, ililink ko na lang sa description para may idea na kayo sa pag-integrate using new substitution. Okay, so for the first problem, we have the integral of x plus 3 times quantity x minus 1 raised to the 5th power dx. Okay, so this one is algebraic functions. So gagamit tayo ng new substitution. So we let u be equal. So when we are given integral involving algebraic expressions, priority natin na i-let u yung mga expressions or terms na naka-raise sa certain exponent or certain power. In this problem, we have the x minus 1, right? It is raised to the 5th power. So pwede kong i-let u be equal to x minus 1. And then, we can get the derivative of both sides. Derivative of u, that's du. Derivative of x minus 1. So derivative of x is 1. Minus derivative of 1 is 0. So we just have 1 minus 0 or 1 dx. So 1 dx or simply dx. And then, sa substitute natin sa original integral, dapat matransform in terms of u. And then, as well as the differential dx, dapat maging du. So for the x minus 1 first, so that's already equal to u, right? And then, it is raised to the 5th power. So we have u to the 5th. Then, for the x plus 3, so we must transform this x in terms of u. Kasi hindi pwedeng combine yung variable sa integral, x at u. So kung u lang, dapat u lang. So pwede nating kuhain yung relationship ng x sa u using this substitution. So if we transpose the negative 1 to the left side, so magiging u plus 1 is equal to x. Therefore, itong x natin is pwede nating palitan ng u plus 1. And then we still have the plus 3. Then, itong dx is equal na siya sa du. So, simplify natin, we have u to the 5th times u plus 1 plus 3, that's 4, du. And then, pwede natin i-distribute yung u to the 5th, right? So, bali integral ng u to the 5th times u, that's u to the 6th, plus u to the 5th times 4, that's 4u to the 5th quantity times du. Then, pwede natin i-distribute yung integral tsaka yung du so that we can integrate term by term. So, bale, magiging integral ng u to the 6 du plus integral ng, etong 4 ay constant lang, pwede kong igilid, 10 times the integral of u to the 5 du. And then, we can evaluate the two integrals using power rule. So, ano yung power rule? Integral ng u to the n du is equal to u to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 plus c, provided that n is not equal to negative 1. Okay, so therefore, for the integral of u to the 6, that's just equal to u to the 6 plus 1, which is 7, over 6 plus 1, also 7, plus 4 times integral of u to the 5th. So that's u to the 5 plus 1 or that's u to the 6th over 5 plus 1, also 6. Then don't forget plus c for the constant of integration. So we can rewrite this as 1 7th u to the 7th plus, so get the lowest term of 4 over 6. So that will be 2 thirds u to the 6 plus c. And don't forget, i-transform back natin yung u in terms of the original variable, x, so which is u is equal to x minus 1. So finally, we will have 1 7th of u, which is x minus 1, raised to the 7th power, plus 2 thirds u, so that's x minus 1, raised to the 6th power, plus c. So therefore, this is the final answer. Next, we have the integral of sine cube x cosine x dx. Okay, so we now have transcendental functions, particularly trigonometric functions. So again, we can apply u substitution first. So we try to let u be equal to what? So notice that we have sine and cosine. So sine is the term that is being raised to the third power. So mas complicated siya sa cosine. So if we try to let u be equal to the sine x, we will notice also that if we get the derivative of both sides, so derivative of u, it's du. Derivative of sine x, it's positive cosine x dx. So we can have the remaining term in the integral, which is cosine x dx. So therefore, ito yung tamang u sub natin. So pag sinasubstitute natin, magiging integral ng etong sine x that's equal to u, then naka-raise sa third power, so we have u cube, and then itong cosine x dx nga, so magiging equal na lang sa du. Therefore, pwede na nating ma-integrate to using power rule. So what is the integral of u cube du? So u to the 3 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 plus c. So that will be u to the 4th over 4 plus c. Then don't forget, ibalik natin yung u in terms of sine x. So we will have, so I can write it na lang as 1/4, then u is sine x raised to the 4th, or gawin ko na lang sine to the 4th x plus c. So we have 1/4 sine to the 4th x plus c as the final answer. Okay, for the next one, we have the integral of sine 2y times the square root of 1 plus 2 cosine squared y dy. Okay, so ano kaya yung maganda nating i-let u? So, mas complicated yung nasa loob ng square root, which is itong 1 plus 2 cosine squared y, right? So, try nating i-let u yan. So, we can let u be equal to 1 plus 2 cosine squared y. And then, check natin kung mapaproduce natin itong expressions na sine 2y dy sa derivative nitong 1 plus 2 cosine squared y. So, let's try. So, derivative natin yung u, that's du. Derivative natin tong right side, derivative nung 1, that's 0. So, wag ko nang isulat. Plus, derivative of 2 cosine squared y. So, itong 2 constant lang, gilid. For the derivative ng cosine squared y, so chain rule. So, power rule muna. Baba natin yung exponent ni cosine na 2. Okay, and then, copy the base, cosine y. Then, di ba, babawasan natin yung exponent niya ng 1. So, 2 minus 1, that's raised to the first power, or cosine y na lang. Then, by chain rule, itong pinaka cosine y, i-derivative pa natin. So, derivative ng cosine y, that's negative sine y. So, mahalaga talaga kapag nag-integrate tayo ng mga transcendental functions, kabisada nyo yung derivatives formula natin. Okay? Then, don't forget the dy. So, kung simplify natin, we will have du is equal to, so 2 times 2 times the negative nitong sine y, sa bali magiging negative 4 times cosine y sine y dy. Okay, so na-produce ba natin yung sine 2y dy? Actually, hindi same na same yung form. But we can apply here trigonometric identities. So recall that for the double angle, sine 2y, it's equal to 2 cos y sine y. So kung gagawin ko tong negative 4 cos y sine y as, so kukuha ako ng 2 sa negative 4, so may negative 2 tayo sa unahan, 10 times 2 cos y sine y, then dy, etong 2 cos y sine y, that's equal to sine 2y. So, pwede kong palitan as negative 2 sine 2y dy. Right? E din na-produce natin itong sine 2y dy. Okay, ito na siya. Nagkaroon lang ng extra coefficient na negative 2, which we don't need kasi wala siya sa original integral. Eliminate ko na lang by dividing both sides by negative 2. So, by the way, ito ay equal sa du sa left side. So, divide natin both sides by negative 2. So, bali, du over negative 2, that's the same as negative du over 2. Then, cancel the negative 2. We will have sine 2y dy na. Okay? So kapag sinubstitute natin, sige, kopyahin natin yung original integral dito. Okay. So we have the integral of, so bale itong square root, and then sa loob, we let u be equal to 1 plus 2 cosine squared y, right? So u na lang siya. And then ito ngang sine 2y dy, ito siya, right, equal sa negative du over 2. So palitan natin ng negative du over 2. So itong negative over 2, that's the same as negative 1 half, which is a constant. So pwede nating igilid. So magiging negative 1 half integral ng square root of u du. So power rule ulit ito, gawin lang nating fractional exponent yung square root of u. That's the same as u to the 1 half, right? So we will have negative 1 half times integral of u to the 1 half. So u to the 1 half plus 1 over 1 half plus 1 plus c. So bale, we will have negative 1 half u to the, so 1 half plus 1, that's 3 halves, over 1 half plus 1, 3 halves plus c. So magiging negative 1 half, simplify lang natin tong complex fraction. So magiging times the reciprocal of 3 halves, right? So 2 thirds, u to the 3 halves plus c. So cancel natin tong 2. So bale, magiging negative 1 third na lang, right? Negative 1 third u to the 3 halves plus c. Pero don't forget, ibablik natin yung u in terms of the original variable y, which is 1 plus 2 cosine squared y. So final answer will be negative 1 third. Yung u is 1 plus 2 cosine squared y, then raised to 3 halves plus c. So therefore, this is the final answer. Next, we have the integral of e raised to 2x over quantity 1 plus e raised to 2x raised to the third dx. Okay, so we now have exponential function. So we can apply first u substitution. So we can let u be equal to what? So notice, meron tayong 1 plus e raised to 2x na naka-raise sa third power. So siya yung pinaka-complicated expression. So, siya yung ina-let u natin. So, we let u be equal to 1 plus e raised to 2x. Then, check natin yung derivative. Derivative natin both sides. Derivative ng u, that's du. Then, the derivative of the right sides, 1 plus e raised to 2x. So, derivative of 1 is 0. So, no need to write. Plus, derivative of e raised to 2x. So, chain rule. So, derivative muna ng e raised to 2x. So, that's e raised to 2x pa rin. Then by chain rule, imultiply natin sa derivative ng exponent na 2x. Sa derivative ng 2x, that's just 2, right? So, unahin ko na lang dito yung 2. So, we have 2 e raised to 2x, then dx. So, napodos natin tong e raised to 2x dx term sa numerator. So, meron lang tayong extra coefficient na na-produce, which is 2. So, hindi natin kailangan yan. Eliminate natin by dividing both sides by 2. So, we will have du over 2 is equal to, so cancel the 2, e raised to 2x dx na lang. So, substitute na natin sa magiging integral of, ito munang e raised to 2x dx. So, that's equal to du over 2 na lang. Then, over, so, 1 plus e raised to 2x, so u na lang siya, right? So, over u raised to the third power, right? So, simplify natin. Itong over 2, so that's a constant of 1 half, right? So, gilid natin. Bale, magiging 1 half integral ng du na lang over u cube. And then, we can apply power rule. Pero, itong 1 over u cube, iangat muna natin. Gawin natin negative exponent. So, bale, 1 half times the integral of, itong 1 over u cube, that's the same as u to the negative 3 du. So, by power rule, we will have 1 half u to the negative 3 plus 1 over negative 3 plus 1 plus c. So, 1 half times u to the negative 3 plus 1, that's negative 2, over negative 3 plus 1, negative 2 plus c. So simplify natin, 1 half times negative 1 half. So bali, negative 1 fourth, right? Then u to the negative 2 plus c. So itong u to the negative 2, gawin nating positive exponent. So magiging negative 1 fourth times 1 over u squared plus c. Or gawin ko na lang negative 1 over 4 u squared plus c. So, same lang yon. Then, balik natin yung u in terms of 1 plus e raised to 2x. So, the final answer will be negative 1 over 4 times 1 plus e raised to 2x squared plus c. Next, we have the integral of e raised to x sine e raised to x cosine e raised to x dx. Okay, combination ng exponential tsaka trigonometric. So again, applyan muna natin ng u sub. So we can let u be equal to what? So notice, pwede tayong mag-substitution dito ng dalawa. Dalawang way. Pwedeng i-let u natin si sine e raised to x or i-let u natin si cosine e raised to x. Bakit? Kasi kapag ito, sige, try natin itong sine e raised to x as u. Derivative niyan, derivative ng u, it's du. Derivative ng sine e raised to x. So, derivative muna nung sine, that's positive cosine. Copy lang tong e raised to x. Dapat may chain rule tayo dito. So, times pa natin sa derivative ng e raised to x. So, e raised to x then, right? So, sulat ko na lang siya sa unahan. Then, don't forget the dx. So, na-produce natin itong e raised to x times cosine e raised to x dx, right? So, pag sinubstitute natin, bali magiging integral ng itong sine e raised to x, so that's u na lang. Then, itong e raised to x times cosine e raised to x dx, ito na siya, equal na lang sa du. So, ito ay integrable using power rule. So, integral ng u du is, so yung u may invisible exponent na 1. So, u to the 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1 plus c. Or u squared over 2 plus c. Balik lang natin yung u in terms of sine e raised to x. So, that will be 1 half. Yung u is sine e raised to x, then naka-square plus c. Or gawin natin yung ganitong notation, 1 half sine squared e raised to x plus c. Okay, so pwede nyo rin gawin kapag u is equal to cosine e raised to x. So, try it by yourself na lang, pero dapat mapalabas nyo ang sagot is negative 1 half cosine e raised to x squared plus c. Sige, try nyo to. Palabasin nyo kapag ito yung u substitution. Next, we have the integral of square root of 1 plus ln y over y dy. Okay, so this time meron naman tayong logarithmic function, particularly natural logarithm ln. So, u sub muna tayo, so we can let u be equal to what? So, notice, meron tayong square root of 1 plus ln y. So, therefore, yung pinaka-complicated is yung under the square root, which is yung 1 plus ln y. So, i-let u natin yan. So, we let u be equal to 1 plus ln y. Then, get the derivative of both sides. So, derivative ng u, that's du. Derivative of the right side. Derivative of 1, that's 0. So, no need to write. Plus, the derivative of ln y. 1 over y, right? So, 1 over y, dy. E, dinaproduce natin tong dy over y na term. So, equal na siya sa du. So, substitute natin. Bale, magiging integral ng, so we have the square root of yung 1 plus ln y, that's u na lang. Then, ito ngang dy over y, that's du. So, power rule na lang tayo. So, bale, integral ng yung square root of u, gawin natin u to the 1 half du by power rule. So, integral ng u to the 1 half du is u to the 1 half plus 1 over 1 half plus 1 plus c. Simplify, u to the 1 half plus 1, that's 3 halves, over 1 half plus 1, also 3 halves plus c. And then, reciprocal ng 3 halves, that's 2 thirds, times u to the 3 halves plus c. Balik lang natin yung u in terms of y, which is 1 plus ln y. So, we have 2 thirds times 1 plus ln y raised to 3 halves plus c. So, this is the final answer. Next, for number 7, we have the integral of tan z ln cos z dz. Okay, combination tayo ng trigonometric tsaka natural logarithm ln. So, obviously, mas complicated itong L and cos Z sa tan Z. So, try natin i-let u yan. So, we let u be equal to ln of cos Z. Okay, derivative natin. Derivative ng u, that's du. Derivative ng ln cos Z. So, chain rule. Derivative ng ln u is 1 over u times du over dx. So, kung ang u natin dito is yung cos Z, so that will be 1 over u, so which is 1 over cos Z, times derivative ng cos Z by chain rule, negative sine Z dz, right? So, bale, du is, we have negative sine Z over cos Z dz. So, na-produce ba natin yung tan Z dz? Actually, yes, by identity, di ba yung sine Z cos Z, that's equal to tan Z. So, bale, du is equal to negative tan Z dz. Ito na siya, right? Pero, meron lang extra negative na coefficient to. So, divide na lang natin both sides by negative 1 para ma-eliminate. So, we have negative du is equal to tan Z dz. Sige, substitute natin. Bale, magiging integral ng itong ln cos Z. That's u na lang. And itong tan Z dz, that's equal to negative du. Bale, itong negative na to, that's negative 1 coefficient. So, pwedeng igilid, constant. So, bale, negative integral of u du na lang. And then, evaluating this power ulit. So, negative times integral ng u du. So, u to the first yan. So, that will be u to the 1 plus 1 over 1 plus 1 plus c. Or negative u squared over 2 plus c. Balik lang natin yung u in terms of z, ln cos z, right? So, final answer is negative 1 half u ln cos z raised to the second power plus c. Next, we have the integral of e raised to x times quantity 1 minus e raised to x times quantity 1 plus e raised to x raised to the 10 dx. Okay, so exponential function. So, obviously, ang pinaka-complicated expressions dito ay yung naka-raise sa 10 power. Which is itong 1 plus e raised to x. So, try natin yung i-let u. So, we let u be equal to 1 plus e raised to x. Get the derivative of both sides. So, we have derivative of u, that's du. Then, derivative of the right side, 1 plus e raised to x. So, derivative of 1, that's 0. So, no need to write. Plus, derivative of e raised to x. So, same lang, e raised to x dx. So, na-produce natin tong e raised to x dx, right? So, du na lang siya. So, try natin i-substitute. So, we have, so let's start with 1 plus e raised to x. So, that's u na lang, raised to the 10th power. Tapos, itong 1 minus e raised to x. So, dapat itong e raised to x in terms of u uli, right? So, gamitin natin yung relationship sa USAP. So, we have u is equal to 1 plus e raised to x. So, para ma-solve si e raised to x, transpose natin si 1 sa kaliwa, bale u minus 1 is equal to e raised to x. So, bale, yung papulit natin dito sa e raised to x is u minus 1. So, put parenthesis kasi two terms. So, minus the quantity u minus 1. And then, finally, ito na lang e raised to x dx that's equal to du. So, simplify natin. Bale, integral ng u to the 10th times, so distribute natin tong negative 1 minus u plus 1, right, du. So, integral ng u to the 10 combine 1 plus 1, that's 2, minus u, du. So, distribute natin tong u to the 10th, multiply sa bawat term. So, u to the 10 times 2, 2u to the 10th. Then, u to the 10 times negative u to the 11, quantity times du. So, distribute natin yung integral symbol together with the du so we can integrate term by term. So, integral ng, itong 2 constant gilid ko, times the integral ng u to the 10 du. Then, minus integral ng u to the 11 du. So, power rule lang pareho itong dalawang integral, right? So, we have 2 times integral ng u to the 10th. u to the 10 plus 1 over 10 plus 1 or u to the 11 over 11 minus integral ng u to the 11 sa power rule u to the 11 plus 1 over 11 plus 1 or u to the 12 over 12 plus c. So, substitute lang natin pabalik yung u in terms of x na 1 plus e raised to x. So, finally, we have, sige, sulat ko na lang as 2 over 11. Then, u natin is 1 plus e raised to x raised to the 11 power. Then, minus, so yung over 12, gawin kong 1 over 12 na lang. U uli, that's 1 plus e raised to x raised to the 12 plus c. So, this is the final answer. Okay, next for the 9th problem, we have integral of 3 plus ln x quantity squared times 2 minus ln x over 4x dx. Okay, so meron tayong logarithmic ulit, natural logarithm. So, anong ililet yun natin dyan? So, yung pinaka-complicated expression is yung under sa exponent na 2 or yung naka-square, which is 3 plus ln x. So, try natin yung ilet yun. Then, get the derivative of both sides. Derivative ng u, that's du. Derivative of the right side. Derivative of 3, it's 0. Cancel na natin. Plus, derivative ng ln x. 1 over x dx. Right? So, naproduce natin tong dx over x. Right? Ito siya. Du na lang. Sige, try natin i-substitute ngayon. Itong 4 pala, over 4, di ba 1/4 lang yan na constant? Sige, gigilid ko na lang siya. So, 1/4 integral ng itong 3 plus ln x. So, that's u na lang. Then, don't forget, naka-square. So, we have u square times 2 minus ln x. So, yung ln x dapat matransform in terms of u. So, gamitin natin tong u sub na to. So, u is equal to 3 plus ln x. Solve natin tong ln x. So, transpose lang si 3 sa kaliwa. Bale, u minus 3 is equal to ln x. Bale, ln x is u minus 3. So, substitute natin dito as ln x is u minus 3. So, again, put parenthesis kasi 2 term siya. Then, times etong dx over x nga. That's du na lang. Okay, simplify natin. 1/4 integral ng u square. Distribute muna natin tong negative. So, 2 minus u plus 3 na. Right? Then, combine similar terms dito sa 2 plus 3. That's 5. Minus u du. So, 1/4 integral ng... Sige, distribute natin yung u squared. So, u squared times 5. That's 5u squared. And then, u squared times negative u cube, du. Distribute natin itong 1/4 integral, tsaka yung du para ma-integrate term by term. Bale, itong 5 is constant igigilid ko. So, ma-multiply siya sa 1/4. So, magiging 5/4 integral ng u squared du. Then, minus, okay, 1/4 integral ng u cube, du. Then, power rule na lang pareho itong dalawang integral. So, 5/4 times integral ng u squared, u to the 2 plus 1 over 2 plus 1, or u cube over 3, minus 1/4 integral ng u cube, u to the 3 plus 1 over 3 plus 1, bale u to the 4th over 4, plus c. So, simplify natin. Bale, 5 over 4 times 3, 12. U cube minus 1 over 4 times 1 over 4. Bale, 1 over 16. U to the 4th plus c. Okay? And then, ibabalik natin yung u pareho in terms of x. Diba, u natin is 3 plus ln x. So, we will have 5 over 12 times u, which is 3 plus ln x raised to the 3rd minus 1 over 16 u, which is 3 plus ln x ulit raised to the 4th plus c. So, this is the final answer. Next, we have integral of the square root of arc sine of x over 1 minus x squared dx. Okay, so meron tayong inverse trigo function this time. So, una kong gagawin is, pwede kong i-distribute yung square root sa taas saka sa baba. Sa numerator and denominator. So, pwede kong i-rewrite to as integral of the square root of arcsine of x over the square root of 1 minus x squared dx. And then, ano yung magandang usab? Notice na kapag nilet yun natin, itong arcsine x, okay? Diba pag differentiate natin yung arcsine x, mapuproduce natin itong 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared dx, right? So, recall natin yung derivatives ng inverse sine. So, derivative natin yung u, that's du. And then, derivative nga ng arcsine of x, that's 1 over the square root of 1 minus x squared dx. So, ito na siya. Okay, so du na lang siya. So, pag sinubstitute natin, magiging integral ng, so we have square root ng arcsine x, so square root of arcsine x, that's u na lang. And then, ito ngang dx over the square root of x, that's du. So, integrable by power rule. So, integral ng, gawin uli nating fractional exponent yung square root of u. So, that's u to the 1 half du. Then, by power rule, integral ng u to the 1 half is u to the 1 half plus 1 over 1 half plus 1 plus c. Or, simplify natin, u to the 1 half plus 1, that's 3 halves, over 1 half plus 1, 3 halves then, plus c. So, bale, get the reciprocal of 3 halves, that's 2 thirds, times u to the 3 halves plus c. Balik lang natin yung u in terms of x arcsine x, right? So, final answer is 2 thirds u, which is arcsine of x raised to 3 halves plus c. So, this is the final answer. Okay, so I think that's it for this video, integration using u substitution part 2. So, sana ay may natutunan kayo sa video na to at maraming salamat sa panonood.